I built this animated character in 1 week with no experience using a 3D software called Blender. You may be wondering, how did he do it? Or, what was the process like? Or, you're deciding whether or not to like and subscribe right now to show your support to a small developer like me. Anyways, in this video, you will see my process of learning Blender, and by the end of the video, you will see how I went from this chair.
What even is this, bro?
All the way to a cute little mushroom dancing character. I do have a little confession to make though. It really hasn't been a week and it's only been 5 days, Monday through Friday. And you know, your boy has to round it up to a week for that YouTube clickbait. Enough with the talk. Let's get straight into my learning experience.
Cause I want to make a game, guys, but I don't really know what type of game we would be making. Let's just go to the normal base plate. Then I'll talk to you guys there. Let's make a little pair for us, I guess. I'm going to try to do Blender things, guys. Don't even have Blender. I kind of just want to make a little scene for you guys since it's gonna be YouTube type of, you know, area, so I can talk to you guys. I want you guys to like see my character and stuff while I'm talking. I don't know much about Blender, but I do know like how to, I know basic, so I don't really know how to do some crazy things with Blender, you know. I want to make a chair for you guys in here. Let's do that. All right, for this day, I think I'm starting to make like a chair, and this is like before I started the challenge, my 3 week challenge. So this is like what influenced me to start, you know, learning Blender overall. Cause right here, you see me trying to like struggle with controls and stuff like that. You saw me pull up like hotkeys and keybinds to like do things in Blender. Cause I really didn't know how to control Blender that much to see like to do what I want to make and things like that. So this is like me struggling with the I think beveling. Sorry, I didn't know how to I didn't know what it was called, but yeah, you know, and then I could have snapped right there to like the vertices, but I really didn't know that. So this is like just showing you guys my previous experience that I had with Blender, and here's me, you know, trying to, I also knew some coloring, so you guys see like my past experience basically with Blender. So hope you guys enjoy. Yeah, so that was a disaster of me trying to build like before I started this building challenge. Or it's like not really building challenge, it's like learning challenge, I guess. It's 3 weeks I'm gonna do, so this is gonna be my first week. I'll show you day one right after this. All right, day one for my building challenge. So I tried still building with what I knew, so I tried making a girl. Cause I knew there was like a mirror tool in Blender, but you know, I'm trying to still get used to that. I didn't really know how to use it. So yeah, that was a problem, but yeah. So then I started going into tutorials. So you're gonna see me like building, copying a tutorial, because I think learning from like more experienced people is the right way to go when you're starting out. Because oh, how do you know what to do, you know, how do you control things and stuff like that? Well, you gotta look at other people and like learn from, you know, more experienced people. That's why we read like books, like textbooks and all that, just to like see what other people are doing. So this is when I like make a pot, and this pot I'm learning how to select things, I'm learning how to scale things. Even with this bowl, I learned how to bevel. With this wheel, I start learning how to mirror. With this other pot, I think I scale so I can make things flat and stuff like that, and then extrude. So this is a random object that is like I'm learning how to scale in different axes, I don't know. But even this is like barrels. I'm learning how to, I think I learned how to scale with like out one axis. So like without the Z axis. With this sword, I think this sword is teaching me how to do the mirror tool. And yeah, I mean, it was still kind of difficult like doing this. So I had to like search up some things while I am going through a tutorial. And I had like problems with the shield, and the problem was I didn't apply the mirror, which was kind of sad. So yeah, that is my first day one. Hope you guys enjoy. Okay, trying to summarize that, I think day one was basically me learning how to scale, extrude, learning the axis, and yeah, mirror. And that was basically it on day one. I don't really know what to show you, but now we'll go on to day two, I mean, you guys can see by commentary, it's like trying to, you know, commentate over what I did before, which is kind of like hard to do because, yeah, but I'll try my best, you know. So day two coming up. Okay, let's see what I do here. I make a chair. I think this is where day two I'm like learning, or I'm building what I learned from yesterday, trying to use all the hotkeys, keybinds. I also, if you guys see on like the bottom right, it's like where I put or like all the hotkeys I use and stuff like that. But obviously you guys can't see it. It's too fast and stuff like that, which is, you know, on my part. Okay, stop the ranting. And this is where I learned how to, like, you know, mirror. This is how I think I learned the arrays. Okay, this is like new content right here. So I try to build the chair that I wanted to from before, you know, a better gamer chair. So I'm literally just using what I know to build different side projects, as I think that's when you start to like understand, oh, maybe this is when I can use, you know, this tool. And yeah, it's really cool. This, yeah, see, like this is when I use like Origins stuff, or like, you know, learn how to do it in different axes, I don't know. But yeah, and me building a chair, I should have used the bevel, like, boolean tool here, but man, I didn't really know about that. But yeah, that was day two, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. Okay, a little summary about day two. I practiced what I learned from yesterday. I learned array modifiers, hard surface modeling with supporting edges, and I also applied what I learned from yesterday to a new side project, because side projects is when you start to fully grasp when to use those tools that you learned. And yeah, let's move on to day three. Okay, so day three, I started making a bed. Like, mostly what I learned, I think it was good enough for me to like build my own side projects. I don't never want to be like in a place where I'm stuck in tutorial hell. It's like when you just rely on tutorials to tell you what to do. You want to try and make your own project so you can see what, like, what the tools, you know, it applies to like everything you learn in life. You want to try, like, branch out, like, you know, try apply your knowledge to things that you want to do. And when you're in time, it's gonna be, oh, do I need to solve something? Oh, I need a color. How do I color? Well, I gotta search it up. Then you do that over time, you know, you learn skills over time. This is where I make like a, okay, let's talk about like the content now. The potted plant, I learned how to do UV texturing here. This is like really important because I remember I needed to color in Roblox, so this was a skill I learned before this series. So, I mean, I'm getting better at texturing. Like, I never used to do this, but then I understood, like, oh, what things could happen is mostly problem solving, like, skills. Like, oh, how do I do this? Well, you know, it's just because, you know, it's kind of easy, I guess. I don't know, not really easy, but yeah, that's day three, guys. Okay, sorry guys, I didn't mean like everything I do is easy. I mean, like, if you have a problem, you literally could just search it up on the internet and most likely you'll have your answer been solved already. And it takes time to practice like what search terms you need, but you know, just be like, oh, what do I need? Oh, I need this. Just search it up, man. You got this. I believe in you. Okay, so day four, this is where I wanted to do like curves on my chair, you know, saying like, oh, if I need something, you should do this, like search it up. So I'm literally searching up how to do the corners of my chair because I have no idea how to do that. And then, you know, I think what I did was use the boolean tool here as well to like try to get that little thing that goes through the chair, you know, those holes that you see right there. And also that little, like, I think volcano that you guys saw before, it was so that I can like make it come outwards, you know, those two sides that you guys see, like, oh, I don't know what it's called, but it like wraps around your body. So yeah, that's how I like learned to make that chair. And now it's just kind of easy, you know, making these little like, I think TV and stuff like that. It's not really too crazy, it's just a bunch of extruding here. And yeah, so this is when I'm like, oh, I'm kind of comfortable on making things now. Let's make some easier things, you know, like, or let's make some things that could decorate my room, because I got I'm actually kind of comfortable at this stage. So, you know, let's make a carpet here. Oh, you know, I made a carpet. I didn't really like it. So then I went back and started recoloring it again. And then I was like, oh, maybe it should be a square. You know, you don't need to do things perfect on the first try. So yeah, you guys enjoyed that day.
Okay, so day four, what was it like? It was learning about like curve modifiers and Booleans and also how to grab things and like, I don't know, push them to make those curvy things that wrap around you. So I think I feel comfortable on like making some, like, you know, these little objects, the things that don't really take like unique shapes. And I think that's a good point for me to say, oh, I think I'm decent at Blender now. And yeah, let's go on to day five. Okay, so day five, this is where I make a mushroom character. I wanted to, you know, make a mushroom character because, I don't know, you know, characters, I gotta learn to animate something. And if I wanted to animate something, I gotta start like small. I don't want to animate like a dragon or something that has a bunch of parts. So I was thinking of, what's small? And, you know, I could kind of animate. So yeah, this is kind of like Roblox related, because I animate in the Roblox studio, but this is, I think Blender is teaching me how to rig like those characters. I should rig those bones together to the base bone, but I didn't know that. And also, this is now a showcase table for the little mushroom. It's gonna stand on top this little rock right here, and you know, it's just be like, oh, problem solving, like I don't know really how to make this thing, so let's just draw it out on paint, good old paint. Okay, so that was the first week, guys. Next week I'm gonna be start making gaze with what I learned, so that's gonna be fun. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, and take care. Goodbye, everyone.